We present AcTExplore for active tactile exploration on unknown objects. Vision and tactile sensations have significant roles in scene perception, each with unique requirements, motivating the development of AcTExplore. Vision relies on direct line of sight, whereas tactile sensation only necessitates physical contact, enabling perception in challenging scenarios like dark or occluded environments when vision is limited. In this work, we look at the problem of efficiently exploring unknown objects with vision-based tactile sensors like digit that can be mounted on a robotic arm. Tactile sensor perceives contact geometries as depth maps, which will be used as observation at time t for our RL algorithm. We keep a history of interactions in sample memory to encode the temporal information in state representation and will reward actions that align the sensor with the object's surface during extended object exploration. To achieve generalization for unknown objects, we trained our model using primitive objects. To assess the model's performance, we evaluated on ICB objects that were not encountered during training time. This evaluation demonstrates the efficacy of training with primitives, which exhibit generalization capabilities for objects with realistic textures. Intersection over union step graph shows the number of actions required by each method to achieve two criteria, either covering 90% of various objects or reaching 5,000 actions. It's worth noting that YCB objects exhibit varying levels of complexity for exploration. For instance, a small and simple object like a strawberry may only require around 200 actions, while objects with more complex shapes, such as a hammer, may necessitate around 2,000 actions. For objects like scissors, featuring thin long blades, the algorithm successfully covers half of the object within 2,000 actions. However, it faces challenges in exploring the remaining parts due to the small contact area between the thin blades of the scissors and the sensor. Nevertheless, extending the algorithm's runtime adequately covers the entire object. To demonstrate the real-world feasibility of executing trajectories generated by our proposed algorithm, we ran the policy on real 3D objects to explore them within a limited time. In our real-world setup, we placed the 3D objects on a desk with limited or no information about the object's pose. To move the digit sensor, we 3D printed a mount for it and attached it to a UR10 arm. The workspace was defined by the physical constraints and reachability of the end effector. To initiate exploration, the arm was directed toward the center of the workspace, ensuring initial contact with the object. To ensure the safe execution of actions generated by our policy, we have adopted a strategy of lifting the digit in the normal direction of the contact after each contact event while running the policy. On the right, we can see the current depth map perceived by digit and the trajectory taken by the method in green. Here's a trajectory generated by running the policy for 300 actions, where each action corresponds to either a translation of 4 millimeters or a rotation of 15 degrees in the sensor's frame. Thank you for watching our presentation.